I will show you the top 5 features in the latest update of Power BI, August 2019. And the number one feature this time, let's just say I've been waiting around for it for a long time. So stick around for that and find out. If you want to catch up on all the recent Power BI updates, then at the end of this video, just click in the corner and access our complete update playlist. And if you are just getting started or keep getting stuck in Power BI, make sure to check out our complete step-by-step Power BI tutorial. I'm Avi Singh, Microsoft MVP and best-selling Power BI author. And if you want to become a Power BI pro, make sure to subscribe and click that bell so you are notified whenever I go live to answer your Power BI questions. Let's kick off our countdown with number 5, the option a category for Power Platform within Get Data. Let's take a look. So if you go to Power BI and click on the Get Data dialog box, you're going to notice that now we have a new category called Power Platform. As you can see, that's right there. And if I click on that, you're going to find a few options there. There is the Power BI dataset, which will allow you to connect to make a live connection to a model published to a Power BI service. But then there are also options for Power BI data flows and common data service. So not only does this make it more convenient to find it, but it's also a great reminder of the rich ecosystem that exists around Power BI. We're going to cover number 4 and number 3, which are pretty close and related to each other. So we're going to cover conditional formatting warnings and icon style picker for conditional formatting. So icon sets were introduced earlier, and we have seen this in an earlier video. And if I were to dive in here, you can look at conditional formatting. And if I, I was using icons, and this was already available. Now, what is new are these icon sets. Now, you realize that this kind of makes it closer to Excel, which is good. I mean, it was nice and easy to use in Excel, and now we have these icon sets, so you can see that I can quickly select maybe a different pattern, and it's going to pre-populate. Now, you can always override that selectively in using these selection if you wanted to, but this just gives you kind of a nice and quick and easy way to select a set of icons. The next thing we're going to look at are the conditional formatting warnings. So this one, we're using an icon set defined in conditional formatting, but you can also use a measure. So I'm going to show you here that I have defined a measure which returns a specific color. And I believe you can return hex codes as well to be really specific, but you can return color names as well. So first of all, I'm just gonna quickly make a change here to add that as maybe a background color. So I'm gonna format the conditional formatting, and I'm gonna apply background color to the budget variable. And when that pops up, there we go. I'm going to choose, instead of a color scale, I'm going to use a field value, and this is where I can return a measure. Now, this gives me ultimate control over what I want to use it for. Oops, I had a small error in the formula, so let's try that again. So I'm going to go to budget, and I'm going to choose conditional formatting background colors. And in here, I'm going to select field value, and now it should let me select the formula, which is great. And I'm going to hit OK. And well, yeah, it's not very pretty, but you get the idea. This measure is returning that color that is being used. And you can see the kind of flexibility that this can give you. Of course, this is a simple example. For more on icon sets, you can catch up on one of our earlier updates. I think this was covered in July. But what I want to show you here is that what if there's some case in the formula which is returning an invalid value or something that doesn't apply, it's not a valid color. So that is what the new feature is, and it's a handy little feature, right? You know, with great power comes great responsibility. So the using measures for conditional formatting gives you great power, but you know, what if you get it wrong? And that's where this feature comes in. And you see what's happening here, that it lights up this warning icon saying, hey, there's something wrong, something that is not working right. And that is indeed extremely useful. By the way, if you ever want to grab any of this file, or really any file being shown in my videos, you can always go to the URL shown on the screen, just learnpowerbi.com/download. Oh, we're getting close, and we're getting to some really good stuff. Grouping visuals. Now, of course, the heart of Power BI is under the hood, but hey, once you have mastered that, once you have mastered the model, the DAX, or the relationships, you know, you gotta make it shine on the visuals, and this is where this feature comes in and makes it really handy to work with items. So again, think of it kind of like PowerPoint, and sometimes it makes a lot of sense to group items together so that maybe you can set their properties together or scale them together or just move them together or copy paste them together. In this case, I have this set of cards and a background square which I would like to group together, and it works very intuitively, very similar to PowerPoint. So what I'm going to do is I'm just going to hold down my control key and select these multiple items. And it's a little bit tricky to select the square in the back. Maybe I should have started with that, but now all four are selected. And now I can just right click anywhere and I can use this group option. Now, once that is grouped, what you can do is if you turn on the view selection pane option right there, then you can see on the side this group and how it has these different elements. And it's pretty cool. My understanding is that you can also further nest groups within each other. So I can click this and combine it with another group, and it's going to be a group of groups. I'll let you kind of play around and experiment with that. And again, really intuitive to use. Once you click first, it's going to select the group, as you can see kind of right there. But then you can kind of hover over it and click on it, and it can select an item inside that as well, allowing you to easily set the properties for whichever element that you want in the group. But again, it makes it really handy to kind of copy paste or move around grouped items together. All right, we are there at number one, the one that I mentioned I've been waiting with googly eyes. But before that, just one more reminder, if you're getting started or keep getting stuck in Power BI, then make sure to check out our complete step-by-step Power BI tutorial. The number one feature for this update is the key influencers visual. Now, this is nothing new, so you must be asking, like, Avi, why are you covering this now? Because it has now that one feature that it was missing, and that was a must-have, which is measure support. Let's take a look. So the key influencer visual is part of the built-in visuals right here. So I'm just going to add a blank visual here and kind of make it super big. And the key influencer visual, the idea for this visual is that it lets you understand your data and uses the strength of AI, artificial intelligence, in the background. And sometimes data analysis can be looking for a needle in a haystack, and this can help you with that task. So the idea here is that you say, hey, what do you want to analyze? And I just want you to slice and dice and check it based on this feature explained by. So let's dive in. So what I'm going to do is, of course, I'm going to look at my sales. Now, of course, you could add any measure here. It could be a complicated measure like customer gained or churn rate or anything like that. And of course, right now it's not doing anything. And what I need to do is I need to add the fields that I want to try to explain it by. And you can, you know, just go to this and maybe add a few from here. And what I'm going to do is actually switch over to the next visual where I have already added based on a few different things. So let me just do this, see if I can get it working. Sometimes it's not happy until you add enough level of detail. So I'm just going to switch to that one. And the only difference there is that, as you can see, if I select this visual, that I added a whole bunch of fields in here. Now, these are product attributes. This over here is coming from customer in my data set. And way down at the bottom, this is coming from the territory data set. All right. So. And it analyzes and slices and dices. And I was playing around with it, and what I realized was that the model name and product name was maybe a little bit too much detail. So I'm going to remove those and see what the visual does. And yeah, this seemed more meaningful. So if we kind of look into this, so the key influencer now is saying I can analyze whether I want to focus on what factors cause the sales to increase, or I have an option here, I can say, hey, what factors cause it to decrease? So let's just take a quick tour of this. So right now it's saying that, hey, when category is bikes, then the average of sales really increase, and it's showing by that amount, and you can see kind of the graph and so forth. And if I look at subcategories, say, oh, great, this is also, kind of factors into an increase, and you can see over here what's the average without mountain bikes, which is pretty low, and with mountain bikes, it increases by about 2,000 in this case. And of course, as you go down the list and you have all of these things which you can kind of examine, and there's also, so this is kind of one factor at a time, But sometimes you want like a cluster of factors, and that's what this top segments does. So what it's saying is that I found a few kind of related filters, if you will, which lead to high sales. So let's just look at that. So I'm just going to click on one segment. So segment five. So again, what I said was this is combining multiple criteria together. Unlike the first section, the key influences was just looking at one factor at a time. But this one is combining a few of them together and saying, hey, if if you were selling bikes in US and specifically road bikes, boy, then your sales numbers really help, right? It's really a factor. And again, you can click around and look at some of the other segments. Look at that. So it's saying of categories bikes, marital status is single. So single people who are not in Australia or United States, they apparently buy more bikes. Average sale is higher for that. So you can see how this is an incredibly powerful visual, and certainly my favorite use of this might be to get me started on the deep dive analysis. Maybe use this as a first stop and just get a key idea of the data set and then dive in myself and try to understand what's going on. And now it has the key feature that I was waiting for. Earlier, there was no support for measures, but with that, I call this complete, and this is number one at our charts. So that's it for this update, but if you want to catch up on all the recent Power BI updates, make sure to click in the corner and access our complete update playlist. Until next time, power on, my friend. Hey, keep watching more videos and keep learning Power BI. But if you did enjoy this video, I would love to hear from you. So leave a comment, like, subscribe, all the good stuff. Power on, my friends.